I'm Hardlight of VisionExperts.com. Today I'm going to talk about a thing that's called ammo. And the reason why I'm going to talk about ammo is because it kind of fits in my prediction techniques that I'm doing. Like it said there, it says there, analog matrix modulation oscillators. This thing can become rather complex in this state because you have a lot of buttons and rotors and whatnot, and you may go like, what the crap is all this stuff? To be fairly honest, I haven't really figured out yet what all the different possibilities are within ammo itself. I've kind of looked into this whole segment, that's kind of like the oscillators. I've been looking into rearm, which is kind of like a modulation bus matrix, what you would normally use inside of a thing like Thor. But I haven't really looked into the whole battery segment yet. But I will get back to that one. Ammo is kind of like a dual thing. You can use it either as an LFO source, or you could use it as an analog monophonic synth, like I'm doing here. Please make note that ammo is not polyphonic. It's always a monophonic thing. But there are certain setups that you can actually create a ammo and turn that into a polyphonic thing. But that's going to be a tricky setup. To basically make you understand like what ammo does, as an LFO thing, because some people might think to themselves, yeah, it's just another LFO. Well, it's not really just an LFO, let me put it clear. The thing that I'm going to do over here is create a ammo, and by its default state it will act like an LFO output source. As you can see right there, it will actually send out a signal that's a really low audio signal that's being transferred right now, which you can barely hear, but if I'm going to do it like that, you can actually hear what's going on. But by default, it's like a really low oscillator that's being triggered. It re-triggers itself over and over again. Because it's an output thing, I'm going to disable the ID output from the ammo thing, because I'm just going to use this as an LFO source. And that's where this quadruple thingy thing comes in handy. It's just four times an LFO. Anyways, to make the thing sound a little bit more interesting over here, I'm going to take a Maelstrom grain table synthesizer. The shift is going to be triggered by the LFO. So if I press a key right now, it goes like wow, wow, wow. This thing will control the rate right there. And the first thing that comes to mind is like, is that all? Is it just like an LFO? Don't I already have like an LFO? Yes, that's true, you already have like an LFO, you have it right there. It does the same thing. The difference, however, is that is where the power comes from ammo, is that ammo has up to 136 different patterns to select from. While most of the devices that are inside the Reason rack will have a limitation for like 24 patterns or something like that. Beats the crap out of me. I don't understand that. Second of all, you can modulate different patterns with each other. And that's what makes the ammo device rather unique in its setup. The thing that I could do over here is sum these channels right here, which means that I can enable pattern A, B, and C, and D, and sum these, either subtract these, using this voltage procession matrix thing. Processing matrix thing. Yeah, there we go. Because I'm using S oscillator A as a CV output source, I'm just going to sum A or subtract A with using oscillator B, C, and D. Simply put. So I'm creating a new pattern from existing ones. In that case, I could go for a pattern like this. Let's take a random pattern like that. Let's take a random pattern like that, and take a random pattern like this. There. It's all a little bit based on sine waves. Turn oscillator B, C, and D on, right there, and change the rate of these. Change the rate, change the rate, change the rate. At this point, it will sound still the same, because we're just using oscillator A. But in this case, I can start subtracting, either adding, either subtracting C or B. That's B, that's C, and that's D. So this one will now tell, like, oscillator B is subtracting everything from oscillator A. This thing will now say that the output from oscillator A is going to be added by the oscillator C. This thing will now tell that oscillator D or will be subtracted from oscillator A. But other than that, you get a really weird pattern where you go like, this is not even seen somewhere in the reason rack. Because I'm creating a unique pattern that is based on hertz, based on frequencies, so these frequencies are always going to be differently from one another, which makes it really interesting in a way. That's the basic setup. Other than that, you could also take a, well, let's take oscillator B over here and use CV2 and stick that inside of, let's take the filter over here. I'm going to use a comb filter, why not? I'm also going to make a square thing like that. There we go. But because it's all free running, that sometimes has its limitations, because sometimes you don't want to have this thing like a free running thing. You always want to re-trigger that whole thing. That is where the setup with the combinator comes in. I'm going to select the Maelstrom and YAMO. I'm going to say combine right there. To make the whole re-trigger mode enabled, I'm going to turn on each setting the envelope right there, which basically uses the envelope, but it also re-triggers the oscillator. So in that case, every time I trigger the key, I'm just creating dubstep right now. Let's make this even more interesting. I'm going to take a cone plus over here. I'm going to stick this in the... Let's go for this route. Take the motion a little bit downwards. Turn oscillator B on. And I'm going to take a different frequency and put the thing on spread. There we go. Simply put, I'm using a different oscillator, that's oscillator B in this case, to modulate the crap out of the filter right there. But because I have over here a oscillator B that also has its own voltage process matrix thing, I can use different patterns from like oscillator C, D, or A, and can subtract those and add those if I want to. So let's just do that. Let's make things funky. Just like that. So the only thing that I'm doing right now is recreating a complete new LFO pattern that sits inside of the CV2 or the CVB channel right there. So from that angle, it becomes like unlimited amount of different LFOs that you have to your disposal. Of course, it is also an option to use the range setting over here, which allows you to make a pattern that is tempo synchronized right there. So in this case, I can make a 3/4 pattern, I can make a 3/16 pattern, I can make a 1/16 pattern, why not, and make a 1/4 pattern right there. All these patterns are differently from each other, but they are tempo synchronized. And go like, what? Can also reduce the mod over here, why not? There. Creating something funky out of something that's already there. That's just the LFO segment that's out there. Other than that, you can also use ammo as an analog thingy, and that's where it also becomes rather interesting in a way, because you have the possibility here to subtract, either add different oscillators from one another, just recreating your own unique oscillator if you want to. The setup, however, is a little bit tricky, and this took me quite some time to figure this one out, because the thing that you need to do over here is use this little key BD setting right there and set that thing to keyboard mode on. By default, it's set to off. But if you're going to crank the thing all the way open, you get a portamento setup. But the first setting, just like this, is on right there. The thing that I'm doing is just pressing and holding shift to figure out where that QBD setting is set to on right there. So in that case, I'm just going to do that with oscillator A to oscillator D. And the thing that I'm going to do next is enable all these three different oscillators. And the easiest route is to use this setting right there, which enables the rates to be the same as oscillator A. So the next thing that I want is to have the range connected to the keyboard range. And that is this setting right there. And that's 440 Hz. To make this thing listen to the keyboard, I'm going to turn on envelope right there, so it doesn't become like a constant beeping thing, but it actually listens to the keyboard presses that I'm doing. Yeah, that sounds dull, it's just a single sine wave. However, I can take a different pattern again. I can take a different pattern over here, turn envelope on right there, and sum the setting of oscillator B with oscillator A. Turn these on, right there. And in this case, I can sum oscillator A with oscillator B. Right there. I can also do the same thing with oscillator C. Take a different pattern. And sum that with that one as well. Do the same thing with oscillator D. Take a different pattern. Let's take this funky thing. Sine wave, right there. And sum that with the rest. But what's also really cool in this whole setup is that there's also a phase knob with every setting that's out there. So I can change the phase, turning this thing into a pulse width thing. I can also do the same thing with that pattern right there. So you can imagine this, that every waveform inside of ammo has a phase oscillator method. I can change the phase of that whole thing, and this is something that I'm kind of missing with most guys that make a rack extension. They always forget the phase knob. They only do the whole thing with the pulse width thing, like the square. But in this case, I have unlimited amount of possibilities over here to phase modulate any waveform that's out there, simply put. And that's why it's awesome. I feel like a freaking child from kindergarten right now. I have new toys. Yay. Make things sounding a little bit more interesting over here. Why not? It's all an option to do so. Sticking a delay. Or take a unison in between. And what's also really cool about the setup is that it doesn't really require that much CPU usage regarding to stuff like Predator or whatever. Jiggery Pokery has only focused on the synth and its modulation capabilities. And that is one of the reasons why I find it really useful, because if I want to have reverbs or I want to have a unison, I will stick that myself in there. I don't need to have an additional device that has an embedded unison inside of the synth itself, because I already have that right there, simply put. So that's kind of like the way that you could use ammo in two different ways. LFO, I'd use it as a synth, monophonic synth. Anyways, that was just a little bit of a video about ammo and its basic capabilities. Have lots of fun, and I will talk to you later.